Hello students, welcome to Vastek channel. This is Vasanthak from Kanta Engineering College. Today I am going to explain the basics of logic gates. So before starting, we will see what is a gate. So what is a gate? So gate is a building blocks of logic circuit, any logic circuit. Gate is a building blocks of any logic circuit which will take one or more input and will give only one output. So gates are building blocks of any logic circuits or switching circuits which will take one or more input. But the output is a only one, that is gate. In gates are classified as two different types. One is something called as basic gates. First one is basic gates, second one is universal gate. So we have two classification of gates. First one is basic gates and second one is universal gates. So examples for basic gates is we have AND gate, NOT gate and OR gate and exclusive OR gate. So example for universal gate is NOR gate and NAND gate. So what is the difference between basic gates and universal gates? Basic gates can perform simple function. Universal gates are those gates, by using those gates we can implement this function. Like I can implement AND, NOT and NOR by using both NOR and NAND. I can implement this one AND, NOT and this one OR. So that is universal gate. So normally in higher end side in development or design of electronic circuits, they will use universal gates, because by using that gate you can implement all these functions. So it is economically feasible also. So now we will see now the difference Now we'll see now one by one what is NOT gate, what is AND gate, and what is OR gate. This is the basic gates. I told you now we have three basic gates, including exclusive OR, four. So we'll see one by one NOT, AND, and OR. After that we'll proceed into NAND and NOR gate. After that we will proceed into NAND and NOR gate. Fine. So now first so you can see in the diagram here, this is the So you can see here, these are the basic gates. So I told you what is basic gates. So these are basic gates. So these are basic gates. So we have three basic gates here, right? One is one is not, second one is or, and third one is AND gate. What is NOT gate? NOT gate, this is a symbol for NOT gate, where you will, it has got only one input and one output. When you give input A, you will get output X as the complement of A, that is A bar. So we know what is truth table. Truth table represents the Boolean this one function of a logic gate, or it can be something like it represents the output of a logic gates for the all possible combination of inputs. For all different possible combination of input, the output is represented in tabular format, that is called as truth table, right? So now here our gate, not gate, has got only one input. So when input is 0, output is 1. Input is 1, output is 0. So you forget for timing this one. So this is the truth table. But if you take OR gate, what is the truth table? OR gate means output is A plus B. A plus B. This OR gate has got two inputs, one output. So suppose input is 0, 0, then what is output? So you have to calculate this one, 0 plus 0. What is 0 plus 0? 0 plus 0 in binary is 0. 0 plus 1 in binary is 1. 1 plus 0 in binary is 1. Then what is 1 plus 1? 1 plus 1 in binary, you know, 1 plus 1, always 1, 0. So 1 plus 1 is actually, we can take it is 1. 1 plus 1 is 1. OR gate, 1 plus 1, 1. Both inputs are 1, output is 1. So next one is the AND gate. What is the output of the AND gate? So take 0, 0 input. When both inputs are 0, 0. When when any one of the inputs are high, also output is 0. But when both inputs are high, the output is high. Please note, in AND gate, when both inputs are high, output is high. That is, X is equal to A into B. When both are high, output is high. Otherwise it is 0. And here you can see, this is the pin diagram of a particular IC. So for OR gate, we are using the IC 7404. And for NOT gate 7404, for OR gate 7432, and for this one AND gate, it is 7408. Now you take 7404. So this is a 14 pin IC. I told in my previous video about IC. So 7th pin is the ground and 14th pin is the VCC. Now this IC contains 6 gates here. You can see 6 gates are there, like this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you will give the input here. Suppose if you give one input like 1, you will get the output is equal to 0. If you give input is equal to 0, you will get output is equal to 1. So like that, you can test all the gates of the particular IC. Now you can ask, why we need so many gates? It depends. In a complex design, you need so many gates, that time you can use. Suppose take one design. In my design, I need 6 gates. Then I can use one IC. Suppose I need 7 gates, then I have to use 2 ICs. Or if I need 10 gates, then I have to use 2 IC, like this IC. So that is the case. In 7432 contains 4 gates. Here it is 6. Which one? This one is 6. Here it is 4. Because it each gate has got 2 inputs. That's why number of gates are reduced 4. And this is the pin number 1. This is the pin number 2. And this is the pin number 3. Pin number 3 is output. You see here. So you cannot change. You have to remember this pin configuration. You can't say, you can't connect 3 to input and 1 to output. It is according to design specification. So data sheet you have to refer. So this is according to the data sheet. So you cannot use your own input and output. You have to refer, you have to remember this one. In lab also you have to remember this one. Then only you can work in lab. Similarly, we have one more IC, that is called 7408. All ICs here are 14 pin IC. 14 pin ICs, and here also it has got a 4 gates. So this one you have to remember. Clear? Yes. So next one is, we'll move to the next screen now. So we have universal gate. What is universal gate? You know, universal gate is the gate. By using that gate, you can derive all the basic gates like AND, OR, and NOT gate. So first one is the NOR gate, universal. See, this is the symbol for NOR gate. So what is the output of the NOR gate? The output of the NOR gate is when both inputs are 0, output is 1. In case OR gate, when both inputs are 0, output is 0. This is the ulta of OR gate. You see, this is the exact reverse of OR gate. That is called NOR. NOR means what? NOR means what? Let me explain you here itself. NOR means what? NOR means OR and OR plus NOT. Or see, OR and NOT. OR and NOT. Both are combined here. OR gate is combined with the NOT gate. That is NOR. So if you think till here it is OR, right? Then here bubble is there. Bubble means a inverter. Inverter, NOT gate. So it is a NOR gate. Similarly, we have NAND gate. So what is the output of the NAND gate? See here. This is also reverse of a AND gate. 0 0 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 0. In case of AND gate, 1 1 is a 1. Remember this one. And we have something called as exclusive OR gate. This is very important, exclusive OR gate. The one of the important properties of the exclusive OR gate is like when odd number of inputs are there, output is 1. See here, how many numbers of this one is there here? 1 1 and 1, output is 1. But when even number of inputs are there, output is 0. For example, even number 0 0 is even here, right? And here 1 1 is also even. 2 2 1s are there, that time output is a 0. Odd number of inputs are there, then output is a 1. Even number of inputs are there, output is a 0. This is a exclusive OR gate. Similarly, we have exclusive NOR gate, and these are the different IC configuration for different NOR gate, OR gate, NAND gate, OR gate, etc. From exam point of view, you need not to remember this one, pin configurations. Only thing you have to remember, it is a 14.5 pin IC. But from lab point of view, you have to remember which is the input pin and which is the output pin. For example, let me zoom this one, and you can see here. See, for example, if you take this IC 7486, we see which is input pin 1 and 2, which is output pin 3. Like that, if you take one more gate, 4 is the input, 5 is the output, input, 6 is the output. Like that only you have to work. You can't change the pin numbers. Like you can't assign 2 as output pin and 3 as input pin. So pin number 7 is ground. So pin number 14 is VCC. You may ask how you will come to know. For this you have to refer data sheets. For each IC you will get data sheets that you have to refer. That time you will come to know all these things. So this is about basic gates. Now, in this diagram, which type of gate it is? This is AND gate, right? This is AND gate. So now, this AND gate, how many inputs are there? 3 inputs AND gate. 3 input AND gate. So output is 1. Anyway, because gate is the electronic device which has got one or more input and only
one output. So these three inputs are A, B, C. You can see the truth table A, B, C. Truth table something like this: 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. Next, what is the next combination? 0, 1, 0. You may ask, how will you get 0, 1, 0? What do you do? For every combination, you have to add a 1. For example, 0, 0, 1. When you add 1, what you'll get? 1, 1. I said 0, 1, 0. 1 is the carry, 1 year. Then this 0. We get this combination. Next combination, you add 1. That time you'll get a 0, 1, 1. This combination. Next combination, 1 you add. 1 you add. Then 1, 1, 0, 1 carry. 1, 1, 0, 1 carry. 1. Like this, you will get all the combinations. Now, what is output? You remember I told when all the inputs are 1, output is 1 in AND gate. So, last combination is 1. And first combination, rest of the all the combinations are 0 here. So, this is called say truth table. This represents the function of this gate. It is in tabular format. Function of this gate. This is called as truth table. Clear? Yes. Now you see here different gates. So I have explained you already two input AND gate, three input AND gate, 4 input AND gate, 8 input AND gates, etc. So, 2 input AND gate, what is the truth table? Truth table is something like this. Suppose A and B, if I take A and B, and Y is the output. So, here combination is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Output is 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1. This is the truth table for a 2 input AND gate. Similarly, truth table for 3 input AND gate. And we have seen already 4 input AND gate. You can write truth table for 4 input AND gate. I will write truth table for 4 input AND gate. Suppose inputs are A, B, C, D. Take this input. Y is the output. Then what is the table? 0, 0, 0, 0. 4 input means how many combinations are there? Since it is a binary system, you know 4 input means 2 raised to the power 4, that is 16. Because we start from 0, it will continue from 0 to 15. 16 combinations. You will get here 16 combination. First is this one. Second one is 0, 0, 0, 1. Third one is 0, 0, 1, 0. Fourth one is 0, 0, 1, 1. Fifth one is 0, 1, 0, 0. Sixth one is 0, 1, 0, 1. Seventh one is 0, 1, 1, 0. Eighth one is 0, 1, 1, 1. Ninth one is 1, 0, 0, 0. Then 1, 0, 0, 1. Then 1, 0, 1, 0. Then 1, 0, 1, 1. Then 1, 1, 0, 0. Then 1, 1, 0, 1. Then 1, 1, 1, 0. Then last combination is 1, 1, 1. This is 4 input AND gate. Similarly, you think now the magnitude of 8 input AND gate truth table. How many combinations you will get? You think here how many inputs are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Not, it is not 8, it is 12. So, 2 raised to the power 12. You calculate and so many combinations are there. Combination will be there in truth table. Now, output is very simple. You know NAND gate, right? It's AND gate, right? All the combinations are 0. All combinations are 0 except last one is 1. Except the last one is the 1. Clear? So with this basic concept of gates I have completed. Now we will move to the next concept. In the next session we will see what is AND or invert gates and other important logical expression. Thank you.